Pastor Dave had the prayer that day. Pastor Tom wasn't here. I was still up here, and he told me to stay up here. And he just happened to see my name in the prayer request list on the, in the bulletin. And he wanted to pray for me, and he did. And the next day, I'd already talked to Connie and told her that I wanted to call the doctor, and I wanted to come off of some medicine to see if I could. And so I did, and the doctor said, yes, you can do that. And the problem was, this medicine I wanted to come off of slowed my heart rate, but it also controlled my blood pressure. And I've been fighting blood pressure for 20 years. You know, it's just been, it's been under control, but I've always had to take pills of medicine for it. That was a month ago, wasn't it? 4 weeks ago? I haven't taken a blood pressure pill yet. Still running, right in my 120s and 130s. Still running 79, 80, 81, somewhere in there. So I didn't claim a healing, but I gave it to God. And I didn't even realize it. I even told Connie, I don't know why I'm not taking blood pressure medicine. And then the next Sunday, I saw Pastor Dave walk through the doors. God said, there's your reason. Duh, son. You got prayed for, and it worked. It worked for Helen, and it worked for others in this church. Plenty of others. There are miracles sitting in this church right now. It worked for Carolyn, too. Miracles sitting in this church right now. So I want you to understand that nobody loves you like Jesus does. Nobody. And I always reference the second verse. The second verse says, story. I could have had a really different story, but you came down from heaven to restore me and forever saved my life. Now, he not only saved my physical life, he saved my spiritual life, he saved my soul. He gave me a new beginning, he gave me a new life, he gave me a salvation that is worth more than any gold you can think of. So I want you to listen to the song. Listen to the words as we sing. I want you to sing the words. Help us sing it. Because anytime you sing a song, it means more to you. Especially when you listen to what you're singing about. Nobody loves you. Nobody. Not even me. And I love you a lot. But nobody loves you like Jesus does. So let's sing.
Mother-in-law prayed over me, and she was Pentecostal, and when she prayed over me, she spoke in tongues, and I felt a bucket of warm water go over my body, and I knew Jesus had healed me.
Yeah, amen.
And I still went through all the surgery and did everything that I was supposed to do, and I had a Christian doctor at Grand Strand. And I had to have shots in my stomach every day to make bone marrow. It was so painful. But I knew God was going to heal me.
Yes.
And when they had an altar call, I went up too. And I had neuropathy in my legs and feet. And it was for 21 years I've had that. And it's all gone. Yeah. Jesus can do in the he can do the impossible.
Amen. Amen, girl. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Everybody sing?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's do it.
I don't know if I can.
Morning. I see you in the sunrise every morning.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
It's like a picture that you. Love letter in the sky.
special friend visiting this morning from all the way from Southern Wesleyan University, but he's a pastor, friend of mine, Heath Mulliken, and you can be seated if you'd like. We're going to close with a song. It's called Is He Worthy? There's only one worthy.
Amen.
Do you stand with us as we sing this song?
Is he worthy of
Is he worthy?